Today we are going to look at elimination reaction, which has been categorized into two main parts. First one is what's drench-induced elimination reaction, or dehydrohalogenation of haloalkane or alkyl halide. The second one, dehydrohalogenation, because we remove hydrogen and the halogen from what is haloalkane. But today, basically, we are going to deal with the acid-induced elimination reaction, or dehydration of alcohol. Dehydration means removal of water, from alcohol. Let's now look at the first example. Let me take this. This propanol. The propanol is going to react with concentrated sulfuric acid. Before dealing with this, first of all, as usual, as we saw in the dehydrohalogenation of what alkyl halide, first of all, the most important point is to arrange and then identify which are the alpha hydrogens and which are the beta hydrogens. Not only alpha and the beta hydrogens, also we must identify which are the alpha carbon and which is what is a beta carbon. So we have OHM. In case of what of sulfuric acid, we are going to write electronic structure of sulfuric acid, which is written like this. So after that, we are going to identify the alpha and the beta carbon. Our OH here, or hydroxyl group here, is the functional group. So the first carbon bonded to the hydroxyl group, which is the functional group, is going to be what? The alpha carbon. This hydrogen and these hydrogens, which have been not attached to this alpha carbon, also are going to be what? Alpha hydrogen. This alpha hydrogen, all of them will be bonded towards the alpha carbon. The next carbon from what alpha carbon is going to be what is a beta carbon. Again, this hydrogen and this hydrogen, which have been not attached to this what beta carbon, also are going to be what beta hydrogen. This also sort of is a beta hydrogen. So what is going It's going to follow after this step is that we are going to bring this bond from hydroxyl group of water sulfuric acid heterolytically, where there is an equal sharing of pi bond electron pair between hydrogen and the oxygen, where the bond electron pair will be taken by this oxygen, because this oxygen is more electronegative than hydrogen. Now hydrogen will attain positive charge as an electrophile. Even here from what this functional group, which is OH group now will withdraw electrons, not from what alpha carbon, but from what beta carbon by negative inductive effects. So the whole OH group will attain negative charge as a nucleophile. So now that this group has removed electrons from what from beta carbon, then one hydrogen, this one or this one, will become highly positive polarized and loosely held to the beta carbon. So what will be the next now is the OH group to combine with the hydrogen to form water. And so long as we have got negative charges here as what is a nucleophile, this nucleophile will combine with hydrogen here, or with hydrogen here, this beta hydrogen to reconstitute sulfuric acid. Because this is just what a catalyst at the end of reaction must remain as it is, should remain as it is. Therefore, now, so long as we have removed OH group and the hydrogen, OH group from this carbon and then hydrogen from this beta carbon, now here we must introduce we must introduce another bond. We must introduce another bond. This hydrogen, I'm going to write at the top here. This hydrogen, I'm going to write here. I want this hydrogen, I'm going to write here. Plus water. This kind of water elimination reaction. Why elimination reaction? Because we have removed atoms without replacement. We have removed hydroxyl group and hydrogen from our bond without replacing other atoms, which will result in the formation of what? Of another bond here. So our overall reaction now, our overall reaction will be propanol plus concentrated sulfuric acid. Our result here will be C3 carbon double bond, hydrogen plus water. This is the hydrohalogenation. It is dehydration. It's dehydration of what? Of alcohol. We have removed the water from what? Alcohol from what? Alkene. But in case of this reaction, we have dealt only with the 1 bitter carbon. We have dealt only with 1 bitter carbon because our OH group has been situated at the end of what of this alkyl group. So the next step we are going to look at when the hydroxyl group is attached to the interior carbon. When the hydroxyl group is attached to the interior carbon. Let's now look at this type of equation. Let me write this kind of alcohol. Now, the hydroxyl group has been attached mostly to the interior, to the interior carbon, which is what is quite different from what the previous one. Now, it means that we are going to have got a 2-beta carbon, 1-beta carbon from the left hand side from this carbon, which has attached an hydroxyl group. The next one carbon is going to be to our right hand side to this carbon. Now, as usual, first of all, we must demonstrate which is alpha and which is what is a beta carbon. In case of this reaction, as usual, this one is our functional group bonded to this carbon, which is going to be an alpha carbon. Hydrogen, which has been attached to this alpha carbon, also is going to be alpha hydrogen. The next, we start from our left hand side. The next carbon from alpha carbon is rebuilding beta carbon with the aspect of hydrogen. This is going to be beta hydrogen. Also, this is going to be beta hydrogen. Again, we are going to react with the concentrated sulfuric acid. Following step will be like this. OH here, here hydrogen, here methyl group. We are going to deal with this sulfuric acid. First of all, we write this what is electrolyte structure. After writing what electrolyte structure, electrolytic bond cleavage will occur here, where the carbon electron pair will be taken by this oxygen, and it will attain what negative charge as a nucleophile. This hydrogen will attain what positive charge as an electrophile. Then from this point now, electron will be what will be drawn towards an hydroxyl group and attain positive charge, will be withdrawn by negative inductive effects, not from what alpha carbon, but from what this what beta carbon. This action will result one of the hydrogen from what from beta carbon, whether this beta hydrogen or this one, to become highly positive polarizing and lose held to this carbon. So the next step is this OH is going to combine with hydrogen from water, and this was negative with a nucleophile will combine with highly positive polarized hydrogen from water from beta carbon to reconstitute sulfuric acid. So our results here. So now we have removed an hydroxyl group and hydrogen from this adjacent carbon. Now double bond must be formed here. So the product will be like this. Plus water, but from the previous reaction, we have dealt only with the beta carbon from on the left hand side of our functional group. Now we are going to deal with the beta carbon from the right hand side now. The beta carbon from our right hand side, which is going to be like this. This is our OH, which is the functional group bonded to the alpha carbon, and this one is the alpha hydrogen. The next carbon from alpha carbon is going to what? To be a beta carbon with their respective what? Beta hydrogen here we plus sulfuric acid here, which I'm going to write is electronic structure. The bond will be broken here, where the open bond electron pair will be taken by this what is most electronegative atom compared to hydrogen, then hydrogen will take positive charge from here. By negative inductive influence, electrons will be withdrawn from the beta carbon towards an hydroxyl group. So an hydroxyl group will attain one positive charge and one hydrogen from here, either of these three will attain one positive charge as an electrophile. So eventually this hydroxyl group will combine with hydrogen from water. Again, this one, negative charge as a neutrophile, will combine with this hydrogen proton to reconstitute sulfuric acid as a catalyst at the end of reaction. So now the overall reaction now of this hydrogen of alcohol, which will be like this, plus sulfuric acid, which is what is the concentration form. The result will be, we are going to obtain two results. The first one is going to be CH3 carbon double bonding carbon 3 plus water, and another one is going to be here. We are going to introduce that one here. It's going to be CH2 carbon double bond, hydrogen plus water. This is what we call dehydration of alcohol. Thank you for listening.